Hi, welcome to this video on cluster interpretation. Clustering or segmentation is one of the most commonly used data science techniques to find groups or clusters within your data. Now, making these clusters is easy, but interpretation of what these clusters mean is difficult. And unless you interpret the clusters, the clustering itself is of no use. So in this video, I'll be demonstrating the top techniques for cluster interpretation, which are shown right now on the screen. I'll be explaining them with examples and visuals, and there's no complex programming screens. So whatever your profession, you can just sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. You can also experience some of the data science techniques demonstrated on this channel on the channel's website, experiencedatascience.com. The link is in the description below. So friends, let's get started. But do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like, and comment on the video. In this video, we will take data related to customers for a telecommunication company. This data set has got customer information such as the demographic, what kind of services the customer has, as well as the billing information. There are about 40 plus columns. Let us assume that we will make three clusters. The results of clustering is that each customer is assigned a cluster number 1, 2 or 3. Now let us understand what these clusters mean. Let us start with the first technique of dimensionality reduction. In order to ensure that the clustering makes sense, we need to visualize the cluster formation. Now as we have 40 plus dimensions in the customer data and the human eye cannot see very high dimensional data, we need to convert our data to 2D using data science techniques of dimensionality reduction. So here is the clustering results shown on a 2D scatter plot. The three colors, the blue, the green, and the red, correspond to the three clusters. Each point is a customer, and we can see the characteristic of the customers by hovering over the dots. Now, because we see that the clusters are nicely formed and there is no overlap between the clusters, we can say that the clustering algorithm has really worked well. The X and Y axis are the results of the dimensionality reduction techniques. Now, because we have a clear cluster formation on this 2D visualization, if we understand what X and Y means, we will also get an understanding about these clusters. The good news is that the dimensionality reduction techniques also gives insight into the meaning of the X and Y axis. And this is called Eigenvector Analysis, and which is shown below. On the Y axis, we have different columns, and on the X axis, we have an indication on how important are they for the dimensionality reduction. We see that the total revenue and the tenure have been important for the dimensionality reduction. So let us now redraw the clustering scatter plot with these two columns, the total revenue and the tenure. Once again, we see a very clear cluster formation. In addition, we can also now interpret our clusters. The red cluster is for the customers who pay less and thus are low revenue customers for the telecommunication company. The blue cluster are the customers who are a medium source of revenue for the company and who also have a medium tenure. And the green cluster are the customers with a higher tenure and a higher source of revenue for the telecommunication company. Though this technique works well, there is a little drawback. The fields tenure and revenue are correlated. You can confirm this by looking at the correlation matrix, which is shown here. You'll observe that the correlation between revenue and tenure is 0.78. Which means higher the tenure, higher will be the total revenue. And this makes logical sense. However, this also means that both columns are similar and just having one column is sufficient. So for example, if you take the definition of the green cluster, which says that this is a cluster with high total revenue and high tenure. But essentially we are saying the same thing again, as high tenure would mean also high revenue. So now let us see our next technique on how we overcome this problem. In this technique, the clustering remains the same and we have our usual assignment of customers to a cluster. However, instead of using a 2D visualization like a scatter plot, we will use a radar plot as shown here, which will help us to visualize data in multiple dimensions. The radar plot has got three areas, the red, the blue, and the green, which corresponds to our three clusters. On the right hand side, you have the dimensions which are related to the calls, such as the night calls, the evening calls, and the day calls. And on the left hand side, you have the dimensions such as the tenure, as well as the services such as internet services, online backup, tech support, streaming movies. And you'll observe that most of the differences between the clusters is on the dimensions on the left hand side, which are related to the tenure and the services. So for example, the green cluster is the one with the customers with the highest tenure and who are using all services such as the internet service, the online backup, the tech support and streaming movies. And the blue cluster is the one with the lowest tenure and a moderate usage of all services. And the red cluster corresponds to those customers who have only the phone service and they do not have digital internet services. So we can say that the green cluster is those customers who are digitally engaged and with high tenure. The blue clusters are customers with moderately engaged digital services and with low tenure. And the red clusters are the basic customers with only phone service. Now this is a higher quality cluster interpretation compared to the earlier method. We have moved from revenue oriented cluster definition to a customer behavior oriented cluster definition. In the previous methods, the interpretation approach was manual, as we had to manually look at visualizations to understand the meaning of the cluster. So enter machine learning, which will save you from stressing your eyes on visualization to identify the cluster meaning. We have columns in the data as our input and the clusters as the output. And machine learning will find the pattern which is connecting the input to the output. One of the widely used machine learning algorithms is called decision tree, which is shown here. We see that the customers who do not have internet services are classified as the red cluster. For those who have internet digital services and less tenure are classified as blue cluster. And those having internet digital services and higher tenure are classified as green cluster. So this is the same result as the previous method, but this time we have the results directly without any need to interpret the visualization. Thank you friends for watching. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video.